Hey y'all, I'm Priya and I'm super excited to be here at Build 2021. Welcome to Power BI for the BI professional and data engineer. I'm thrilled to be talking about how you as the BI professional and data engineer can use Power BI to build some amazing reports and help the users in your organization get insights out of data. So let's get started. First, I'm going to talk about our Power BI strategy, and then we're going to go into some major investments we've made in the last couple of months, and then I'm going to do some demos as well. We'll wrap it up with a few actions you can take from this session. So our mission here at Power BI is to drive a data culture so that everyone can make every decision at any scale, replace opinions with facts based on data so that they can take appropriate actions. So let me start off with an example. We have hundreds of customers that have consolidated on Power BI, and I'll talk about a customer like Humana. Humana is a healthcare insurance provider, and as you know, over the last year and a half with COVID, companies, organizations have had to make major decisions based on data. And this is no different for Humana. Humana has had to look at massive volumes of data and evolve new company strategies. Now, Humana decided to make a digital transformation a couple of years ago, and they chose Microsoft as their partner. At first analysis, they realized they had over 47 different disparate systems and BI tools. The first decision they made is to consolidate that into a simple, singular solution architecture and chose Power BI as their primary tool. Now, when COVID happened last year and they had to figure out new strategies for their company and for their members, with their employees working remotely, it wasn't a big deal. With the singular architecture and with Power BI, they've been able to attain it. And now, not only are their users thinking about using Power BI for COVID strategies, but also for using in their other daily operations. And you may ask, how did they do this? So that for the rest of the time I have here with you, I am gonna talk about what Power BI offers and how can you leverage that. So let's go into a little bit more detail into the Power BI strategy. At the core, at the heart of our strategy, we want to empower every individual to build that data-driven culture. So we've built Power BI with amazing data experiences that are powered by AI and infused by AI experiences. Now, every individual can make that decision, and that's where it starts. Next, we want every team to be empowered to make every decision wherever they're making those decisions, whether it is in those productivity tools, like Microsoft Word, Excel, Office, whether it's those collaboration tools with their colleagues, such as Microsoft Teams, and we want them to be able to automate those actions. Lastly, the third pillar of our strategy is to empower every organization, because at an enterprise level, this is not about a singular user. It's not even about tens of users. It's about hundreds and thousands of millions of users. And when you start growing that big, you got to think about scale, performance, and meeting the most demanding needs of the enterprise of governance and security and scalability. Let's talk about this third pillar. I'm going to deep dive into how do you, as the data engineer or the BI professional, connect, transform, and prep data. How are you going to build those amazing reports? How are you going to take care of performance at those large volumes that I talked about? And how do you distribute to millions of users all with governance and meeting your security needs? I'm going to start off with the first thing. You want to connect to your data, you want to transform your data, and you want to prep that for analytics. So let's talk about connecting to data. If you've been with us on the Power BI journey over the last several years, you know we've got hundreds of connectors, and we keep working with the ecosystem to add more connectors every single day and enhance existing connectors. So we make it super easy for you to connect to your data and bring it into Power BI, whether that's on-prem or in the cloud. Now, what I'm excited about is transforming data. We made it super easy for you by bringing visual data prep capabilities via a capability called Diagram View. Now, I'm excited that is now generally available to you. You can easily drag, drop, use this visual interface that's in front of you to create your data prep steps, which can be super complex. You might have to connect multiple tables, join the data, remove the data, filter the data, and there could be many, many, many dependencies. And you know, these data prep steps, you might want to see data at each step, preview the data at each step. We make it all easy via the diagram view and this simple interface. So this is generally available, and I'm super excited that it is now generally available to you. Next, now that you've transformed your data and you've prepped it, you might think about, hey, I might actually need to save those data prep steps and reuse it and make my data prep interoperable across the organization. We've actually done that as well in Power BI. How? Via our integration with Azure Data Lake Storage Gen 2. So we make it very easy in Power BI to prep data quickly via a common data model. If you haven't used that or you don't know what that is, the Common Data Model is an industry standard format that we've built working with customers, various customers in the industry, and it gives you a data format very specific to your industry. So you can prep your data very quickly, and you can create reusable building blocks for data prep across your organization and store them in Azure Data Lake Storage Gen 2, so that any other application, any other service, whether it's Dynamics or your own application, can leverage that same data prep step, and it's highly interoperable. Now, this capability was in preview for a while, and we're super excited that over the last month, we brought it also to general availability. So I look forward to more of you using it to create data prep steps. Now, what I'm super excited about next is to talk about some really cool capabilities where it's not available yet, but it's coming to you really, really soon. And this is streaming data flows. Now, as you know, we live in a world where we're connected to IoT devices that are streaming data by the second, whether it's a smartwatch connected to the human body, whether it's a connected car or a connected home or a connected hospital. There's just devices everywhere, and data and telemetry is streaming in. Now, you probably know that it's easy to build reports with batch data, but not so the case with streaming data. If you had to bring this data into Power BI, you would have traditionally probably had to write a ton of code to connect to that streaming source, right? Connect that to that device that is emitting that data via an eventing source, and then figure out how to bring that data into Power BI. There's probably a lot of lag time, a lot of code written in this process, and then you build the analytics on top of it, which may not end up really being in real time. Now, the capability that we're bringing to you, and you will be able to preview it really, really soon, is streaming data flows. So streaming data flows allows users like yourself to ingest data, to mash it up with other reference data that you have, to build reports on that data in real time, and all of this within the Power BI service, within that same user interface that you've been using over the years to do your analytics. So I'm excited to show you a demo. I'm gonna do some New York taxi fare data analytics. And I have a streaming data source that is streaming New York taxi location data and fare data based on the pickups and drop-offs that are happening in Manhattan. So let's start off by looking at how I create a streaming data flow. So I go into my Power BI service. Here I say new streaming data flow, and this is the same intuitive interface that I've been using. And I say create a new streaming data flow. Now This now takes me into an interface very similar to the diagram view, where I can drag and drop my data source, connect to that eventing hub. Here, I can preview that New York taxi data that's streaming in real time. I can now connect it to an output table. If you guys have used Power BI data flows, then this output table is nothing but an entity or a table within Power BI data flows. I can also do many other operations like joins, like mergers, group bys, and unions. I can bring in reference data if I want to. Here, for the purposes of this demo, I'm just going to go in and do a group by, and I want to group it by a tumbling window of about 10 seconds, and I'm going to put that into an output table. Right? So I'm streaming my data from an eventing source and I'm sending it to an output table. All of this, just a few clicks, and I save that streaming data flow and I start it. Now, the cool thing is I can now go build a report on top of this. Here I'm using Power BI Desktop, my tool to build my report, and I'm gonna go ahead and find that streaming data flow that I just created in the service. And here, I'm going to choose that streaming data flow, and I'm going to also select another data flow that is bringing some other data along, and I'm going to load this. Now, you can see I haven't done much. I'm going to connect to it in direct query mode, and I've got my canvas ready. Now, I can start picking and choosing my fields to do my FAIR analytics. So I'm going to start looking at FAIR time, and I want to look at the FAIR over the time. So you can see this is what I'm seeing, which is FAIR over the time as those taxis are moving around Manhattan and picking up, dropping off passengers. Now, I've already built a report, a fully completed report that does this taxi analytics. And let me show you this report. What you're seeing here is a map that is showing me all of those taxis that are moving around Manhattan. I can see the fare that's changing over time. And hey, I'm doing some analytics here based on fare revenue and ratings. And I'm able to see that when the vehicle type is shared, it seems like my revenue is maximum and I'm getting the highest rating. So that was really, really simple, right? A few clicks and I've been able to bring in streaming data into my analytics along with some batch data. You didn't have to go to Azure, you didn't have to write much code, and we've built all of this within Power BI by leveraging the capabilities of streaming that exists already right within Azure. So now that we've built that report, let's talk about something else interesting. Enterprise semantic models. Now, you guys already know about semantic models. Within Power BI, they're called Power BI datasets. They house the business definitions of data, all the key performance indicators, and all the business logic behind the data. So let's talk about what's new over here. Now, you've probably built these semantic models traditionally in Azure Analysis Services, and that's probably because we've had a lot of gaps in Power BI in terms of features. Now, over the last year, we put a very big concerted effort into bringing all of those features that were in Azure Analysis Services into Power BI. And so Power BI Premium is now a superset of Azure Analysis Services. We brought to you the XMLA endpoint. Well, you say, what is that? So with the XMLA read-write capabilities, you can keep that enterprise semantic model right within Power BI. So you have all that business logic, all those rules within the Power BI dataset, and you have a single source of truth. But you can use any third-party tool, not just Power BI or Excel, but you can use Tableau, Qlik, or any other tool to read and write that data set. So you don't have proliferation of business logic all over your enterprise. We also brought to you late last year the capabilities of large models. Power BI now can scale up to 400 gig model size in memory. It's quite amazing. Also, we brought to you the integration with Azure Log Analytics. What this helps you do is monitor, debug, troubleshoot your own performance with all the great performance telemetry that we have within Power BI. And you can do it easily. We've also brought to you object level security in February. What I'm excited to announce today and talk about is the next capability, which is Backup and Restore, that is now available as well in Power BI Premium. Now, if you've been using SQL Server Analysis Services or Azure Analysis Services, you know how important Backup and Restore is, not just for disaster recovery, but also to be able to migrate your models. And here now, you can do exactly that. Backup and restore from SQL Server Analysis Services or Azure Analysis Services into Power BI without reloading your data. Just go into Power BI, turn on your settings, and you're going to backup to an Azure Data Lake storage account, and you can restore from that very same Azure Data Lake storage account into Power BI Premium. It's it. Very, very simple. And that way, now that model that was in Azure Analysis Services or SQL Server Analysis Services is immediately available in Power BI as a Power BI dataset, just like you see it right here. So do try it out, and I am super excited about this feature. Now that we've talked about building semantic models, let's move into performance. Now, I know as a data engineer or a BI professional, you care about performance. It's top of mind. You want to give your business users the best performance. You want your models and your reports to be highly, highly performant. Now, you also know that this is not an easy task at all. What I'm excited to talk about today is a new feature that's coming to you by end of June. It's called automatic aggregations. Now, if you've been in the BI world, you know that BI queries are mostly aggregates, right? It's total sales, total revenues. Maybe users will start drilling down by geography, by state, by zip code. And when they do, we go directly into the data source and grab the data. But for most of the part, it's aggregates, and these aggregates, when they're stored in memory or within Power BI caches, will give you the best possible performance. Now, a couple of years ago, we got brought to you a feature called aggregations, but the challenge with that feature was that it required somebody like you to go think about what are those aggregates to create, right? Is it total revenue, total sales? Well, geez, that was not an easy job, is it? Because it requires analyzing query patterns and doing quite a bit of query optimization. Now, automatic aggregations does exactly the opposite. It's automatic. We, Power BI, automatically create those aggregations for you. And how do we do that? Because we know users, we know what they're querying, we collect those querying patterns over time. And we have an ML algorithm that automatically creates those aggregations in Power BI memory. And when users are trying to open those reports, we surface the results from within those aggregates, all of this automatically. And guess what? The best part, it works over any big data source. Whether you will keep it in SQL DB, whether you keep it in Synapse or Snowflake or BigQuery, it just works, people. And also, it's an ML-based algorithm. It optimizes over time and it's self-learning. So you don't have to do all of that. We do the heavy lifting for you. So I'm excited to show you this demo today. And I will be super excited for you to use it in about a month or so from now. Okay, so let's get right to the demo. Here I have my New York taxi report. Let me tell you a little bit about it. It's running over 3 billion rows of data sitting in Synapse, and it's in direct query mode. So I have my performance analyzer here, and I'm gonna refresh a visual. As you can see, I'm still refreshing. Not surprised, that's a large volume of data and lots of complex queries. And here you see just one visual is taking over 30 seconds to refresh. Okay, and as I click and drill down, it's taking more time and the report is kind of getting a little sluggish. Performance is getting sluggish. I'm gonna go into my data set and I'm gonna now turn on automatic aggregations. I can also set up a refresh frequency, which tells Power BI how frequently I want that aggregation to be refreshed and how frequently I want the ML algorithm to redefine the aggregates. Come back here. Refresh my visuals, and just look at that. That took about a second or so to refresh. And every time now I start clicking through and drilling down. Then Power BI sort of looks at these querying patterns, it starts defining new aggregates, and instead of going directly to the Synapse data warehouse and retrieve that data, just pulls these from memory, these aggregates from memory, and gives the user superior performance. However, as a user, as the creator of this report, I might be interested in knowing, well, how are these aggregations actually helping me? So we're providing you with a beautiful lift chart where you can go in and you can say, well, my business SLA is about 5 seconds for meeting query response time performance. So in pure DQ mode, only 60 percentile of my queries are hitting that threshold. But hey, when I am turning on automatic aggregations, close to 80 percentile of my queries are meeting that SLA. And then I can play around with this as well, and I can say, well, I actually want 85% of the queries to be cached, and what percentile of my queries are gonna meet the SLA bar? Well, I can do that right here as well, and I can also do trade-offs between aggregates in memory and the performance I wanna meet. That's it. So this will come to you in June, and I hope you use it and improve performance. Next, I want to talk about performance telemetry in Log Analytics. I talked about this being available to you, and I want to let you know that all of this automatic aggregation telemetry that we just talked about is going to be available to you in Log Analytics as well. And we're going to be shipping this with a few out-of-the-box template apps, so you can use those and you don't have to write your own applications. Or, given that it's in Azure Log Analytics, you can just build your own applications as well. Now I want to switch to enterprise reporting and distribution. Now, those of you that have been with us in the journey of Power BI over the last 5 years, you probably know about paginated reports. We took the capabilities of creating pixel-perfect operational reports in SQL Server reporting services and brought it into Power BI, brought it into the cloud. And it's been an amazing hit because you do have those scenarios where you want to create those printable reports, those invoices, those orders, and you want to distribute it to millions of users and business partners. Now, what I'm excited to talk about today is new capability that is bringing the world of interactive reporting that you saw so far with paginated reports via a paginated reports visual. Now, this is shipping in our June desktop release, and what you will be able to do is build your report that bring together that interactive report with the paginated report via one simple visual. So as you can see in this example that I have here, thank you, Paginated Report Bear, for pulling this together for me. Well, I have on my left-hand side stuffies that I'm selling, and my right-hand side I have a paginated report that is giving me the total sales results. And as I'm interacting with the report, as I'm picking different stuffies, I can see my paginated report with my total garage sales revenues. Isn't that so awesome? Can't wait for you to use this in a couple of weeks or so. Next, I want to talk about governance. This is really important. We take security at Power BI and governance at Power BI very seriously. Power BI protects your data, and we want you to be rest assured about these things. Data residency. We have the largest global footprint in the world, and we manage content in over 54 different data centers worldwide. We provide the most number of certifications of any BI tool in the industry, and we meet the most stringent compliance and security needs. We also take network security very seriously. We have capabilities such as virtual networks, private endpoints, and we ensure that only certain clients are able to reach Power BI. We also take encryption seriously. Data is always encrypted, in rest or in motion, it's encrypted. And then lastly, we know how important data loss is, and we want to prevent it, and we want you to protect your data. And especially in this world of working remotely, we know this is critical. So how are we doing this? We're doing this via our integration with Microsoft Information Protection Sensitivity Labels. For those of you that have used Microsoft Word or Office or Excel, have probably seen this. You can apply a sensitivity label, such as general, confidential, highly confidential to a document. And that makes sure that only the right people who can access that document can do that. Now, that same integration is available in Power BI to your Power BI artifacts, like your Power BI report. But what I'm going to talk about is end-to-end data loss protection. So you're building a report that's based on an email address that's sitting in Synapse. Well, that's highly, highly confidential. You bring that data into Power BI. Power BI inherits that sensitivity label, as you can see with that little lock icon here. And not only that, all the downstream reports inherit that as well. Here I have this report that is showing me that it's inherited that same highly confidential sensitivity label. And it doesn't end there, right? If I try to export this report into PowerPoint, which is a very common thing users do, that same sensitivity label travels forward as well. So we make sure your data is protected all the way from Azure to Power BI to Office. The last thing I want to talk about here is a totally cool new feature that we've just announced this month in May and is available to you in preview. You know, so far we've built report, we've tweaked the performance, we've made sure it's protected. Now, one thing that enterprises do need to do is think about how they're going to measure their objectives and key results and do performance management. There's a cool new feature in Power BI called Power BI Goals that lets you do exactly that. Set your goals within Power BI. And the power of Power BI is that it's so easy for you to connect to those myriads of data sets and build those reports. So why not track your performance and your goals and your metrics right within Power BI? And not only is it available within Power BI, you can also make it enable it such that your teams can collaborate using Microsoft Teams. These goals are powered by AI and users can automate actions as well. Now, you no longer need those spreadsheets or all those other tools to maintain, manage, track your performance goals as an organization. That's it, folks. That was a whirlwind tour of some of the capabilities that I think is going to help you as the data engineer or the BI professional. Now, what do you do from here? Call to action. I would suggest watching another session that's going to tell you about how to embed your analytics, you know, all of these great analytics that you've just created, how to embed that using Power BI Embedded. And the other thing I would suggest, whether you're new to Power BI or a veteran, I would suggest going back to our documentation. There's a ton of new updates and all these features that I talked about are going to be available in the documentation as well. So that's it, folks. Thank you so much for watching and stay safe, stay healthy, and until next time, thank you.